So friends, we are back again. We have started a short tutorial series on different experiments. As I have told in last tutorial also, and I have written in the LinkedIn, etc., that there are, I think, 350 to 400 engineering institutions, diploma, degree, diploma, if I consider even more. In Maharashtra, Karnataka, there are many engineering institutes. But my general opinion after the service experience of academics as a teacher for about, 29 years, I should have seen that the theory portion is given due weightage, but the practical, the laboratory is not given weightage. Most of the laboratory teachers are explaining things. They are teaching theory. Laboratory means no words, no teaching. Student should do wiring, student should take experimental readings, no doubt. Some explanation may be required here and there so that the students may come to know as to what they're expected to do. But out of 2 hours of experiment, teacher should not speak for more than half an hour. For remnant 1.5 hour, student should be doing an experiment and they should conclude something. That is what is not happening. The main reason is this, that there are no equipment in the institute. If at all equipment are there, they are not utilized. If at all equipment are there, people do not know what kind of experiment can be generated out of those equipment. Simple equipment are there, but very nice experiments can be developed. We have seen one experiment as to how we can test overcurrent relay, that is normal, very extremely inverse overcurrent relay. We can test instantaneous overcurrent relay. We can test thermal relay with a simple test bench of not more than 5,000 to 10,000 rupees. I mean, very simple cost. Any engineering institution can bear that cost and can design a very good experiment. And then what teachers do, that is what I've seen in my engineering college. I've seen that teachers take the laboratory class for half an hour or 45 minutes or at the most 1 hour. Time is 2 hours. Remnant time is free for students, for teachers also. Both are enjoying. Both are at ease. They are getting full salary for 2 hours and they are teaching for 1 hour. Students are also happy because they are not to be in the institute for a long duration of time. They are not learning, but they do not understand. But when they go in practice, they have not understood things that they do not understand because they are yet kids. They are yet small. They do not know. Teachers know. teachers must take 2 hours. When I used to enter the laboratory, usually 4 to 6 was my laboratory hours. 6 hours the college was closing, and the peon usually would come and just start closing the window. I used to instruct the peon that when I am in the laboratory, you should not enter the door. You are not allowed to enter the door of the laboratory. When I leave the institute, and when I leave the institute out of the door, out of the BVM door, when I go on the road on Vidyanagar, then only you will enter, then only you will close the window, and otherwise you will not close the window. My laboratory class will start at 4, will end at 6:15. 2 hours and 15 minutes, because after 6 there is nothing. So, my dear teacher friends, please take full time, please teach fully, please take pains to teach things. So today we are going to talk about a simple experiment, transient overage. Everybody must be knowing that our power system is inductive. And in any inductive circuit, whenever the fault occurs means normal current was 100 ampere, fault current is 1000 ampere, 100 to 1000 jump cannot be there, and therefore there will be asymmetricity in fault current. I am not here to prove that asymmetricity mathematically. For that, you are most welcome to subscribe my module number 2 of power system protection, which is uploaded on mobile app AdaptMe, which is available on Android environment, not on Apple, not out of India yet as on today. After a week or so, probably it will be available out of India also. But in India, you can subscribe. No doubt, you will have to pay. 500 rupees is the cost. But then fault calculation and substation is the module. In that fault calculation, how in the RL circuit the transient comes, what is the mathematical background that is given. I am not here to talk about mathematical background. But what happens that current is asymmetric, and therefore the current seen is more, and more means relay feels as if the fault is nearer. Therefore, fault is away, fault is not within its zone, but relay feels that it is within its zone, and therefore it operates. I should not say maloperate, it operates. It correctly operates, but it is not within its zone. Therefore, that is a wrong operation. That should not happen. And it is transient, because that asymmetricity is going to die down after a few cycles. After about 30 cycles, it is going to die down. Therefore, no time delayed overcurrent relay. No time delayed overcurrent relay suffer from the problem of transient overage. Transient overage is a problem of instantaneous overcurrent relay only. And for that, we have designed a very beautiful experiment, a very simple experiment. The relay was purchased in 1963, old HBB, sorry, not HBB, yes, Hindustan Brown Brewery, not ABB, Hindustan Brown Brewery. Not Hindustan Brown Brewery also, we had purchased from BBC at that time, Brown Brewery Company, Switzerland. And it was a very simple relay. It did not have any special facility. If the current exceeds 2.5 ampere or 5 ampere, relay operates instantaneously. Nothing. No more facility. Simple relay. You cannot do any experiment. Pass current 2.5 ampere. It operates instantaneously. Show to the student. 5 minutes. Go. But we did not allow the student to go. We made an experiment out of that. My friends, for any queries, for any difficulties, for any consultancy, my phone numbers and email ID are given. You are most welcome. Next slide. The reach of the relay is that part of the system protected by the relay if a fault occurs. If I want to protect the transmission line AB, if the fault occurs within AB, it should operate. Beyond B, BC is the another transmission line. Beyond B, the relay should not operate. a relay that operates for a fault that lies beyond the intended zone is said to overreach. And when using an instantaneous overcurrent elements, this problem occurs. And the initial current's duty, what is a DC offset? It is not DC offset, my dear friends. It is exponentially decaying, but it exponentially decays over a period of 30 cycles. And my instantaneous overcurrent relay operates within 1, 2 or 3 cycles. So within that time, I can consider it DC. Therefore, the technical name given is DC offset. Therefore, what is the theory? Theory, we do not want to talk much. You see, in practical, we will not talk much about theory. Instantaneous overcurrent relay operates as soon as the value of the current exceeds the set value, even though this high current may be only for few cycles. Set value say, bad jayega. When a fault occurs, a DC component is introduced, and this DC component maloperates a relay. So, what is the circuit? The equivalent circuit is like this. RL circuit is like this. E is the source. Current is passing R and L. Unfortunately, L is very large in our system. If you compare XL and R, XL is equal to R in 11 kV system, 11 kV transmission line. XL is about 3 times R in 66 kV transmission line. XL is about 5 to 6 times R in 132 kV. XL is more than 6 times R in 220 kV system. XL is equal to 8 times R. And if you say tan inverse XL by R is equal to 8, you will see that it will be about 85 degree. Therefore, when the fault occurs, the angle between current and voltage is very large. When fault does not occur, angle is, you know, cos phi, 36 degree, 30 degree. Right, but when fault occurs, the angle is very large. Not only that, but if you solve this equation, it is Ri plus Ldi by dt is equal to E, and that equation is a differential equation, and that differential equation, if you solve, it will be like this. So I am not here to talk about this because it will consume too much of time. I am telling short tutorial instead. Many of my tutorials have gone to 1 hour. 1 hour is not short, I do know, but I am helpless because you see the things are that difficult. So right now I am not talking about this. The PPT is available with you. You can see the video as many times as you want. This is free. This is on YouTube. So you can visit the video as many times as and pause this and see what is E is equal to Ldi by dt plus Ri. And if you solve this equation, the transient component is A e raised to minus RT by L. And the steady state component is Em by Z, that is Im sine omega t plus theta minus pi. Now, what is this theta? That you should understand. Theta is the angle at which the fault occurs, right? Angle at which the fault occurs. I don't know that. No, it's not given. It's not given. I'm sorry. It's not given. That slide is not given. But theta is the instant at which the fault occurs, right? So my steady state component, I know it is sinusoidal. But omega t, you know, phi is the angle between voltage and current, you know. Theta, what is theta? Theta is the instant at which fault occurs. Voltage wave shape is passing. If fault occurs at voltage 0, then theta equal to 0. If fault occurs at voltage equal to maximum, theta is equal to 90 degree or any other value. Now, if you see, when will the fault occur? Fault occurs when the voltage stress is more, and voltage stress is more when voltage is maximum. That is true. But you see, there are many reasons of fault which does not depend upon value of the voltage. Say lightning stroke. Lightning stroke does not see whether the voltage is passing from zero or maximum. It can occur at voltage zero also. And if it occurs at voltage zero, and because in our inductive circuit phi is roughly 90 degree, therefore when voltage is zero, current is maximum, maximum DC offset will be there, doubling effect will be there, and that will cause relay to maloperate. I should not say maloperate, operate correctly, but then it operates. So what will be the wave shape? Wave shape is like this. Wave shape is like this, my dear friend. Wave shape is like this. DC offset, it is, I have not shown exponential. It is a mistake of the drawing, the person who has drawn. It is not straight line. It is exponentially decaying. And it has been shown decaying within hardly 2 or 3 cycles. It is not show. It decays after 30 cycles. But unfortunately, I cannot show on this screen 30 cycles. Otherwise, these cycles will be very small and you cannot see. So you have to assume certain things. So for 1 or 2 or 3 cycles, you can see that it is, you can say that it is DC offset. So what has happened? You can see in steady state, the current is small. In transient state, current is large. So instantaneous overcurrent relay is either this first peak or second peak or third peak, because after 30 peaks, it is steady state. So when one first, third, second or third peak it sees more current. And what is the meaning of more current? More current means fault nearer, because relay does not know more or less. Relay feels that more current means E upon Z. I is equal to E upon Z. If Z is less, I is more. Z is less means distance is less. That means if the current is more, distance is less. Actual distance is more, but relay feels that distance is less. So relay maloperates. This is my problem. And this I have proved in my experiment, that this happens. How does that happen? That I have proved. So what is the theory behind that? The theory behind that is ZS by ZL. ZS is the impedance from source to relaying point, and ZL is the impedance from relaying point to fault, right? So if ZS is large, the overreach can be as bad as 2 times ZL plus ZS. And if ZS is large, the overreach is too large. 2 times ZS means, 2 times ZL means the line is 100 km long, fault occurs 200 km away, but yet relay operates. That is the meaning of truly overreach. But that truly overreach never occurs. Relay does not operate in 0 time. It takes 1 cycle or 2 cycles. So that way the overreach is going to reduce, right? So there are many reasons because of which overreach will not be as bad as we are talking theoretically. Usually it is said, people say that the relay is maloperate or relay is overreached by 20%. Relay is overreached by 20%. So if I want to protect 100 km long line, I will not protect 100 km long line by instantaneous relay. I will protect 100 km long line up to 80 km by instantaneous relay. And that too for 3-phase fault, not for 2-phase fault. Maximum fault current and 80% of line. I assume that 20% will be overreach. This I have been telling to many student friends. What is the theory behind it? That there was a theft done in Akbar's Darbar, Akbar's city. Some jewelry was there. Chori means a ornament seller. So many ornaments were stolen. So he came to complain to Akbar that my ornaments are stolen. Akbar asked him, whom do you doubt? He said that there are 4 of my servants, I doubt them. So Akbar told Birbal that find out who is the culprit. So Akbar, Birbal, what did you do? He told that I will give you a good air conditioned room, all 4 in 4 different rooms. You will be given good food, you will be given good bed, you will be at ease, you will not be punished. But I will give you a stick that is magic. Abhi Gujarati mein hai mantra likhiye. I don't know how many of you, because so many of in the world would be hearing my video, so they would not be understanding Gujarati. But it is a magic stick that the person who has stolen the ornament, his stick will be 2 inches less in the morning. All others will be same. his stick will be his stick will be 2 inches more. His stick will, the length of the stick will increase by 2 inches more. I am giving 12 inches, 1 feet stick to everybody. But his stick, the person who has stolen, uski stick will be 2 inches more. So obviously what did he do? He cut 2 inches and he was caught. That's exactly what we have to do. My relay reaches by 20% more. Instead of 100 kilometers, it goes to 120 kilometers. So what do I do? I make it to reach up to 80 kilometers so that it can go up to 100, not beyond 100, because I do not want to go beyond 100. My line is 100 kilometers long. So this is the whole theory behind it. So for doing this simple experiment, my dear friends, for doing this very simple experiment, I had got two relays. One was a 5 ampere electromagnetic relay. That means if the current is more than 5 ampere, it will operate instantaneously within 3 cycles, maximum 3 cycles. And another was static relay, which was 1 ampere relay. So for both of them, I had planned a circuit. Circuit is very simple. 230 volt supply, everybody, all colleges have. Auto transformer, all colleges have. 230 volt input and output 0 to 270 or 0 to 300 volt. Simple. All colleges will have such an auto transformer. And what is the capacity? Hardly 4 ampere, 8 ampere is enough. Nothing is required. I am not fetching too much of current from the source. Another thing what I note, C2 and C3 are the contacts of contactor C2. Contactor generally is not available in colleges. So you will have to buy, you will have to purchase a contactor. Then if you want, you may not use a transformer, but if you want, you can use a transformer, 230 by 40 volt step down transformer, so that your current, when you are changing the current, your current resolution is quite nice. So, but that 230 by 40 volt 1 kVA transformer is also usually available with all laboratories. In BBM, we had many transformers like this. So that is not a problem. 50 ohm 1 ampere reactor, that you have to probably purchase because that is not available, right? 50 ohm 1 ampere reactor. But 18 ohm 12 ampere resistor, usually you will have, otherwise you purchase. Single pole switch is a simple thing. Aapke ghar mein hoti hai, everybody have. 15 ampere switch also, if you want to purchase, you can purchase. Not very costly. It's very cheap. So my whole experiment is very cheap. Now my problem is, I am passing 1 ampere in primary or 5 ampere in primary, and I want to pass more current in secondary. Because you see, if you just see, I am passing 18 ohm of resistance plus 50 ohm. So 15 plus 20, 70. 70 ohm is my resistance and 40 volt. So 40 divided by 70. So 40 divided by 80, pakadlo, to be 0.5 ampere is my current. And I want to pass 5 ampere. How can I pass? So what I do, I am using a CT in a reverse way. 5 by 25. If I pass 1 ampere in secondary means in actually in primary, I am wiring here and primary in other side. So 5 ampere will pass through the relay and relay will operate, because if the current exceeds 5 ampere, relay will operate. I have got an ammeter to see whether the relay has operated after 5 ampere or not. What all I will do? I will keep the auto transformer at zero. I will make the contactor on and then slowly increase the transformer. When 5 ampere reaches, relay will operate instantaneously and I will come to know that yes, relay is operated correctly. This is one thing. Second thing, 1 ampere relay, I do not need a CT because my circuit is taking 1 ampere. So simple circuit, same circuit, no CT, right? Same circuit. So this is the same circuit. Now the control circuit. Now the other two circuits, as you have seen, you have to wire. Means you will have to ask the students to wire. Means auto transformer student will have to take from auto transformer output, they will have to wire the 230 by 40 volt transformer, then resistor, reactor, CT, relay coil, emitter, everything they will have to wire. So they will have to do some work. right? But contactor is there. Contactor, you have not to wire. Contactor is not. So the auto transformer is having a 3-pin plug. That 3-pin plug you will insert after contactor only. So contactor is permanently wired. C2 and C3 are permanently wired. This control circuit is also permanently wired. Control circuit means, if I want to make the contactor on, I should be able to make it on. If I want to make it off, simple. Make the PB1 on. Try to understand that PB1, PB2, PB3. PB1 is NO, means it is normally open. If you press, it will close. PB2 is NC. If you press, it will open. PB3 is NC, right? But they are spring loaded. If you press PB1, it will close. If you remove, it will open out. So I press PB1, PB2 is NC, auxiliary relay contact 7 and 11 are NC, so contactor coil is energized and therefore C2 and C3 will close, and therefore your supply is through. You can start your experiment. One thing. Second thing, that C1 is on. Therefore, even if you release your hand for PB1, contactor will not de-energize. Now, after certain time, that is after 2 cycles, 1 cycle, instantaneously relay will operate. So, contact, NO contact of overcurrent relay will operate. So, that will energize one auxiliary relay. This auxiliary relay you do not have, so you will have to buy, right? So I will in first experiment I told as to what all you have to buy and all as to what all you have. That I had told in this, probably I will not tell you. You have to understand that certain things you will have to buy, but they are not very costly. If you just see, they are not very costly. Contactor, I told you, 2000 rupees. Auxiliary relay, hardly 1000-2000 rupees. These push buttons are nothing, 50 rupees, 40 rupees, right? Nothing. Indicator lamp, I mean, many things are switch, simple switch, 15 ampere switch, at the most 50 rupees, 25 rupees, 30 rupees. Very cheap things are there. You can design a very good experiment at a very, and you can pass full 2 hours, and student will gain quite a good lot of knowledge. My many friends who are seeing right now or who will see afterwards this video, I don't know how many. I want that 100 should see today, tomorrow 1000, day after tomorrow 10,000, and after 1 week, after 1 month, after 1 year, 1 crore of people should see my video and should see that many things are possible in power system. Many things are possible in electrical. Electrical branch is now very cheap. Very low number of students are going. In GSET, a very good institute in Vallabh Vidyanagar, 60 seats are there, official seats. 20 seats are filled. Why? 120 seats should be. Electrical is the only branch. It is a very good branch and it must be fulfilled. People are mistaken. Parents are misled. Electrical is a very good branch. Probably, I'm sorry. Probably something is wrong somewhere. Maybe teachers are not teaching properly. Maybe students are not learning properly. Maybe management is not seeing to the things that let the people come to electrical branch. Give me the chance, I'll tell. I was given the chance once upon a time. There were 60 students in my class. 40 did not like to come to electrical. They wanted to go to I2 and CP. Within 6 months, everybody told me that, sir, electrical is the only branch in which we should go. That is teacher's job. That is teacher's job. Magic teacher ko karna hai. Jadoo teacher ko karna hai. To aap jadoo kariye. To ye sab cheez simple hai. So when the relay operates, what happens? Auxiliary relay will operate. Auxiliary relay you will have to buy. When auxiliary relay operates, auxiliary 1, 7 and 11 will open out. So contactor will de-energize, circuit will be disconnected, relay will be out of circuit. And then once again, as we had seen in first tutorial, you can measure the time of operation That means once you make the contact on, timer will start when the relay operates. That means when the auxiliary relay operates, timer will stop. Third contact of auxiliary relay you can use for stopping timer, and you can measure the time. Actually, time measurement is nothing. It is instantaneous. You need not measure also, because it is instantaneous. There is no use in measuring time. Our main point is not measuring time. Our main point is overreaching, how far it overreaches. Now, when NO contact is on, the contactor is going to be off. Contactor is going to be off. So when contactor is off, relay, there is no current in relay. So relay will de-energize. When the relay de-energizes, that NO contact will come back. So auxiliary relay will de-energize. That should not happen. So auxiliary 2 will hold auxiliary. And you can de-energize your circuit only by pushing PB3, accept or reset button. So that is all the thing is. In presence of 230 volt supply, this is all what I explained, control circuit. You can read through everything I have explained. I am not again explaining. Things are available. You can pause and see. When you see the video, I am going ahead. What are the procedural steps? Aapko karna kya hai? Experiment kaise karna hai? Connect the circuit on the performance panel as shown in figure 3.5, either 1 ampere relay or 5 ampere relay. Set the wiper of the rheostat to such that the resistance is zero, because we want to keep first resistance zero. Only XL. Maximum reactance. So maximum overreach. Set the pickup of the relay to 5 ampere. 1 ampere relay rated at 1 ampere. Means if at all it is 1 ampere relay, set at 1 ampere. 5 ampere relay, set at 5 ampere. Switch on means pickup you have to set in the relay at 5 ampere. Setting you have to do at 5 ampere. Switch on the supply. Make the contactor on. Kaise on karoge? Simple. By pushing PB1, make the contactor on. Then what do you do? Make the contactor, switch on the supply, set the auto transformer so that the current through the relay coil is 4.5. See, 5 ampere relay operates instantaneously. 4.5, it does not at all operate. I have set at 4.5, so relay does not operate. Now, you switch off the contactor PB2. Don't touch the auto transformer. Try to understand. Auto transformer you have adjusted at 4.5. Don't touch it. Don't change it. But PB2 you press. That means contactor is off. Then press PB1. See whether the relay is operated. No? Okay. Then once again press PB2. Make it off. Then PB1 on. Make many trials. At one particular trial the relay will operate. At one particular trial, because of DC offset, the relay, it is quite possible that on the very first trial it may maloperate, second it may maloperate. Why? Because the maloperation or the operation depends upon the instant of voltage at which you are switching on and you are not seeing. Therefore, by chance, if you switch on at voltage zero, then the relay will maloperate, otherwise not. And you do up to 50 times. After 50 times you stop, because then relay will not maloperate now, right? So that is what you have to do. This is the procedural step. Note down the switching counts. It operated after 5, 6, 7. Repeat the procedure from step 6. Repeat the procedure from 8, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Repeatedly make the switch S1 off. Repeat the procedure 6. For currents, decreasing order in steps of 0.5. Matlab ki first time you started at 4.5, second time you take 4. Whether relay maloperates at 4, whether relay maloperates at 3.5, whether relay maloperates at 3. I saw, my dear friends, that my 5 ampere relay maloperated for 1.4. I adjusted current 1.4. Relay operates at 5. But at 1.4, it operated. That was the worst DC offset. That was what we had observed. Now what you have to do? You had made the resistance zero. Now what do you do? Add the resistance. Say X by R is equal to 8. So R is equal to 6.25. X by R is equal to 4. When you start adding the resistance, your DC offset decreases. Therefore, the possibility of maloperation is decreasing. DC offset is less. Because in resistive circuit, there is no DC offset. If X is completely removed and only resistance is there, then there is no DC offset. Then there is no maloperation. Then there is no overreach. But very unfortunately, our power system is highly reactive. The inductive reactance of generator, large generator, 210 megawatt generator, 500 megawatt generator is about 50 times resistance. Mind you, try to understand. Hear me again, 50 times resistance, XL. XL is equal to about 50 times the resistance for large transformer also. And transmission lines I spoke. Our system, if load is absent, and when fault occurs, load is absent. Because fault occurs means load is shorted. Therefore, you see, the system is highly reactive and therefore overreach does occur, and overreach is our problem, and overreach, you have to find out the solution to overreach. Until you cannot find out the solution to overreach, you assume that it will overreach by 20%. So you set the relay for 80% of transmission line to be protected for three phase fault. Yes, but there are ways and means. In static relay, you can differentiate the current and thereby you can reduce the overreach. By differentiating mathematically what happens, for that you will have to buy my module number 2 uploaded on AdaptMe, which you can download from Google Play Store, and you can buy that and you can see all mathematical background behind that. Tabulate all readings. Kaise tabulate karo? So you have to tabulate. So this is what is trying to be shown, how you will calculate the overreach. So IF1, for that I have to see this figure. I want to protect line AB, but fault occurs at IF2. There also the relay maloperates. So what is the value of X ampere? What is the value of Y ampere? Source impedance is ZS, that is from source up to relaying point R. ZL1 is the impedance of line AB. ZL2 is up to fault F2, right? So if you see, so it is proved that IF1 is equal to EPH upon ZS plus ZL1, that is Y ampere. IF2 EPH upon ZS plus ZL2 X ampere. If ZS is ignored, for the sake of simplicity, if I ignore ZS is equal to 0, then Y is equal to EPH upon ZL1 and X is equal to EPH upon ZL2. So ZL2 upon ZL1 is equal to Y upon X. ZL2 minus ZL1 upon ZL1, Y minus X upon X. So ZL2 minus ZL1 is what? B2F. ZL2 minus ZL1 is B2F. Whatever. So ZL2 minus ZL1 is B2F. ZL2 minus ZL1 is BC up to C, that is up to fault. And ZL1 is AB, that is my main line, and that is equal to Y minus X upon X. And BC upon AB is percentage overreach. Try to understand. BC means up to F2. BC upon AB is the overreach, is the percentage overreach. And that is, what is the formula for overreach? Formula for overreach is Y minus X upon X into 100 in percentage. So that is what I'm going to do. So what I will do, I will now tabulate the readings. R equal to something, X equal to, say R equal to 0, X equal to 50 ohms. Current for 5 ampere relay, 3.5, 3.5, 3. Number of times I made the switch on off, 4 times, 5 times, 7 times. Relay status, tripped or not tripped. Tripped then right, tripped, not tripped then right, not tripped. If not tripped, then there is no question of calculating overreach. If tripped, then y minus x upon x into 100, right? What is the formula that we derived? Y minus x upon x into 100. So y minus x upon x into 100 that you calculate. What is y? Y is your setting, 5 ampere. X is the value you are adjusting, 4.5, 4, etc. So percentage overreach you can calculate for one particular hour. Take next hour. Koi dusra hour le lo. Jada. X by R ratio is more. So percentage overreach will decrease. And that is what we want to prove. Practically, we would want to prove. Right? We would want to prove practically. Then third resistance, fourth resistance, fifth resistance, sixth resistance, seventh resistance. You can go on taking different resistance and prove that if resistance is more, the overreach is less. What is the summary? The problem of transient overreach is applicable to instantaneous overcurrent relays only and not to time delayed overcurrent relays. Number one. Number two, problem of transient overreach appears in reactive circuit only, not in resistive circuit. Number two. Number three, unfortunately, power system is inductive and therefore overreach is always there. If by chance, if you make the switch on at voltage maximum, then probably overreach will not be there. But you can't say, you don't know when you're making it on, right? Making it on at a particular instant is a very costly arrangement. It is known as point on wave switching arrangement. If you want to make the switch on at voltage zero or voltage maximum or at a particular instant of voltage, that arrangement, point on wave switching, is, I think, if I mistake not, some 50,000, 70,000 or 1 crore rupees. So no college can think of it. So we have to just try, trial and error. By trial and error, you see, by trial and error, you may not get overreach. By trial and error, you may get overreach. Magnitude of overreach depends on instant at which fault occurs, that I told. And therefore, generally what we do, we set the transmission line, instantaneous overcurrent relay, we set for 80% of line section to be protected, for triple line to ground fault. This is what we see. Instantaneous overcurrent relay maloperates. What is the conclusion? Instantaneous overcurrent relay maloperates for the faults outside its zones of protection due to transient overreach. That is our conclusion. That is what we have practically seen. We have seen by our own eyes. We have seen by our own hands. Not by professor who is talking. Right now I am talking. But you will do this experiment. You will wire this experiment. And then you will see by your hands, you will see by your eyes, you will hear by your ears, you will do everything, no teaching, no theory, only practical. I don't want any theory in practical. I have seen in many engineering institutes, particularly online classes, 2 hours time. For 1.5 hour, the teacher is speaking. I ask the teacher, why are you speaking? This is practical. Sir, we are sorry. We have to consume 2 hours. Otherwise, our management will drive us out. So then I would go to management, drive me out. I won't speak anything theory in practical. Drive me out. If you are capable enough, drive me out. 72 years old person, 40 years experience. Complete Gujarat is knowing, power system protection expert Purnesh Soza, drive me out. They will not be able to drive you out. You have to see to it that you teach in such a nice way. Practical means pure practical. In online also practical. I have done that in PDPU. We have done online purely practical. Practical panel was there. The operator was operating push button. He was showing, see, I am pushing this button. See, that relay has operated. See, this thing has come. Online also, you can do practical. Not so. But you are talking theory. No. While practical, no theory. No, not at all. Not for 5 minutes also. No theory. Yes, for talking something, for introducing something, 5-10 minutes, okay. Transient overreach can be simulated in laboratory by rapidly switching on and off the mechanical switch. You can have a mechanical switch or push button, and more the value of resistance in load circuit, higher the current at which the overreach is observed. That is, overreach is reduced if resistance is included in the circuit. That means if power factor is improved, then the overreach is less. This is all what PhD people are doing. When people are doing thesis, they are doing this. But when they are doing PhD, they do not have this conceptual idea that I have seen many a times. When I have gone to, as an external examiner in PhD, because I am not myself not PhD, but I have gone as an external examiner for master's dissertation, I have seen that people do many big algorithms and big things and optimization and phalon tekan. I mean, big things they do. But what is plug setting? What is time multiplier setting? What do you mean by instantaneous operation? What do you mean by 3-second relay? What do you mean by 1.3-second relay? What do you mean by normal inverse characteristic? What do you mean by very inverse? Oh, sir, we know only algorithm. We do not know normal inverse. Then what the hell you are electrical engineer? If you are doing an algorithm, go to computer. Don't come to electrical. Electrical is all this. Normal inverse, very inverse, extremely inverse. This is electrical. Algorithm is not electrical. Go to IT. Go to computer. Don't come to electrical, right? So I am very strict about these things. So friends, this is the things. Future scope. What can be the future scope? Future scope, exactly, I've told in a different way. We had done this future scope because you see, just doing this experiment, people will not publish the paper. The big Springer and IEEE and kya bade bade naam hai, wo log itne jaldi se paper publish nahi karte. They don't publish the paper like that easily. You have to show big things, big names. If you show white color, they will not publish. You have to say red, yellow, blue. You have to say colored things. So my friend, my very good friend, Dr. Rasesh Mehta, who is right now head of electrical engineering department at BVM Engineering College, he told that, sir, he was my student also. He told that, sir, let us give this your simple experiment a color. So usne kya? What he did? In my white experiment, he filled in the color. What color he filled? He rather simulated whole experiment on MATLAB and compared my practical results with MATLAB results. Both were matching. See, both are matching. IEEE fellow said, yeah, wow, very good, nice, very good paper. This paper can be published internationally and some 100 people will rather caught that paper. If I would have published that simple experiment, nobody would have, oh, this is a simple thing. Usme kya hai? Not only that, we went to third step. We asked Mr. Manish Kumar, a very, very intelligent student of mine. He is my student. I never say my student was. Rashesh is also my student. Manish is also my student. Rashesh graduated in 1989. Manish graduated somewhere in 2008-2010. But then very, very, very intelligent student. Right now, he passed his UPSC and he is with Railways, Western Railway. We gave him a work that you tap two leads from resistor and feed it via some isolation transformer to storage oscilloscope and measure that DC offset under different conditions of X by R. So whatever we have calculated experimentally, whatever we have calculated by MATLAB, the same results we confirmed on storage oscilloscope. And once on storage oscilloscope it will remain there for 30 seconds or 1 minute. He took photographs. He took 8 or 10 photographs. Paper was published in Manipal Institute of Technology, MIT, international conference. So this is research, my dear friend. This is research. I don't know what people, somebody told, somebody gave rather remark for me that somebody's PhD thesis, rather viva was going on, final viva was there. So usually other people will come, external examiner, internal examiner, student, and some 10 other people, good people will come. So one person told that, shall we call Mr. Professor Oza? So external internal examiner told that, who is Professor Oza? Professor Oza does not have any research contribution. Bhuvanesh Oza ka research contribution kya hai? Yes, right. You are very right. That fellow is very right. I am a dull person. I have no research contribution. But I have my research contribution is live persons. Dr. Rashesh Mehta, Jita Jagta Insan. He is my research contribution. Manish Kumar, who is in Western Railway, he is my research contribution. Your research contribution is dead paper. What the hell you are talking? Your research paper is not research paper. This is research paper. So we published a research paper. Future scope, you can publish a research paper. We confirm by physical experiment, simulation in MATLAB, and the oscilloscope results were exactly matching, and therefore that paper was published. That was the future scope. My friends, I'm sorry, my voice goes little high because I have got little different ideas about teaching and learning process. I have got very different ideas about, I have different ideas about syllabus also. Somebody will prepare syllabus and he will call me to teach. I don't teach syllabus. I teach what is required in the field. दुनिया में क्या चाहिए वो सिखाना है ना, तो देन यू प्रिपेयर योर सिलेबस अकॉर्डिंग टू व्हाट इज रिक्वायर्ड इन इन द वर्ल्ड. यू आर नॉट डूइंग दैट एंड यू आर आस्किंग मी टू टीच योर सिलेबस. आई डोंट डू दैट. सो आई एम लिटिल डिफिकल्ट पर्सन, अ डिफिकल्ट टीचर. आई हैव रिमेंड अ डिफिकल्ट टीचर फॉर लॉन्ग 26 इयर्स, बट येट वेरी मच लव्ड बाई माई वेरी बिग ग्रुप ऑफ 2000 स्टूडेंट्स. Many of them would be hearing me now, and many of them are giving very good comments on YouTube. Many of them are giving me very good comments on WhatsApp. They love me very much. I love them very much. Manish Kumar is also equivalently lovable student. I love him very much. So with all my odd behavior, many students love me because they have reached at a very high post. They have reached at a very high post. So this is what is there. So I end with a sentence. Faith is, what is faith? Vishwas kya hai? Shraddha kya hai? What is faith? To believe what you do not see. Faith means you can't see. You can't see. God is there? No, you can't see the God. You can't see God. To believe what you do not see. The reward of which, uska parinam kya aata hai? The reward of which, what is the result? The reward of which is, you see what you believed, you start seeing. Aapko Bhagwan dikhai dena shuru hota hai. Kaise dikhai dena? You are yourself God, my dear friend, you are yourself God. Aap hi Paramatma hai. Aap hi mein Bhagwatta chhipi hai. Aapne aap kisko di? Aap dekh kis liye rahe hain? Aap sun kaise rahe hain? आप खा कैसे रहे? हाउ यू आर टेकिंग ब्रीद? आपकी सांस रुक जाएगी तो क्या होगा? आप ही परमात्मा है. टू बिलीव व्हाट यू डू नॉट सी इज फेथ, बट द रिवॉर्ड इज यू सी व्हाट यू बिलीव, माय डियर फ्रेंड. विद दैट माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, आई एंड वंस अगेन आई recall, रिमाइंड दैट डोंट फॉरगेट दिस नेम एडपमी. एडपमी इज टीचिंग यू फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट very good things. Now I am teaching very simple experiments which can be run for 2 and 2.5 hours and at very low cost. So friends, don't forget this name, Edupme. Many big people are there in the market. EdTech, many big people are there. I do not want to name them because I do not want to make them down. Main unko chota nahi dikhana chahta. Main bada banunga. I will increase the length of my line. I will not decrease their line length. But there are many people in EdTech. EdUpMe is one more. remember Adapni, remember Adapni, remember Bhuvnesh Oza, remember Apurva Oza, remember Harshal Oza. They are the directors of Aptrace Technologies Private Limited, and they have designed this app not only for power system protection, for many things. Please go through Adapni. Please go through website. Thank you, friends. Good day. Or I should not say good day. Good night. Raat ho gayi mere yaha India mein. I cannot say good night because at USA it is good morning. At other Dubai it is good evening. But as far as India is concerned, it is good night. Thank you all. Thanks everybody.